The weather just isn't cold enough to build the annual ice castle in Eagle River. The ice on Silver Lake isn't as thick as it should be. The castle is usually built between Christmas and New Year's Eve. This is video from last year's castle. Well, plenty of ice at Slice of Ice here in Milwaukee. We found skaters celebrating the new year on the rink at Red Arrow Park. Great weather for skating now that it is actually warming up a bit, and snow is on the way too. Here's Chief Meteorologist John Milan to tell us more.
Yeah, we really haven't seen much in the way of snow. Our snow season has been very meager, 10th of an inch in October, 4.7 in November, only a half an inch in December, and that came back on the 2nd. So it'll be a month tomorrow that we haven't seen any snow around here. We got up to 31 degrees in Milwaukee today, 41 St. Louis, 39 Des Moines, 30 at the Twin Cities. All this warm air surging northward ahead of a storm system that's rolling in our direction for Saturday and Saturday night. 29 still in Milwaukee, 26 Port Washington, where you got a couple of breaks in the clouds. We dropped to 22 in Sheboygan, 23. In Waukesha, overnight temperatures will drop to about 19 near the lake in Milwaukee County and 19 in Port Washington, 18 Sheboygan, 17 in Waukesha, holding right around 20 in Racine and Kenosha as those clouds break up from north to south. And you can see the breaks in the overcast coming in from the north, and then they start to fill right back up. Actually, a couple of flurries for you folks in Sheboygan County as a weak wind shift line rolls through. And there we go back out, pulling out and showing you all the moisture to the south. The storm developing across Texas, that low pressure system will be moving in our direction into Saturday and Saturday night. High pressure is blocking it right now, but it moves out of the picture by tomorrow, late tomorrow, tomorrow night. And here comes the low pressure system from the southwest. As it moves through, it'll start to bring a rain mixture late morning into southeastern Wisconsin. This computer model has it a little further south. The snow will be riding right along that polar front. That's really going to be dropping the temperatures on Sunday and into Monday. This computer model showing about 2.5 inches in Milwaukee, 4 inches Madison to Green Bay, a little less as you get south. Here's what we looked at as we blended all the models together. About an inch or two from Milwaukee County south, we were seeing Kenosha, southern Walworth County. The rest of the area about 2 to 4 inches, and the northern part of Fond du Lac into the Green Bay and Fox Valley area might see 5 or 6 inches of new snow. Tonight we're just going to see some clouds off and on. We'll call it partly to mostly cloudy. About 14, well, inland 21 in the city and closer to Lake Michigan. Again, northwest winds not as strong as we had earlier today and last night. Tomorrow, partly cloudy and seasonal. West winds high right around 28 degrees. Get enough sunshine, could hit 30 again like we did today. And then the clouds roll back in for Saturday. We start out with a rain-snow mixture late morning into the early afternoon. It could change over to some snow. We could see an inch on the ground by Saturday night, and then another couple of inches into Saturday night. High on Saturday, 34 degrees, but that's the warm-up. Then we start to see temperatures drop on Sunday. We start out with 20 and flurries in the morning hours, and those temperatures drop into the single digits by 5 o'clock. Monday, single digits is our high temperature of 8:15. With a chance of a little light snow into Tuesday and back down to 10 on Wednesday, 16 on Thursday. In the morning hours, it's Kaylee Bale. She's 6 years old, adorable young lady, all bundled up, 21 lakeside, 16 inland. So we'll be back to near 30 again tomorrow. This year starting out slightly mild.
Yes, and I like Kaylee because she's fashionably bundled up.
Oh, of course, we always have them fashionably bundled up.
Thanks, John. We'll come